So a lot of those times, some of those noises, those animalistic things are just triggered by an instinct.
The last album, Asylum, is it's out now for a couple of months. How do you look back, or yeah, it's maybe a big word considering that, but how do you look back on it now? What has it done for you maybe, or what marks it in your career?
Just very proud of it. I mean, with each album we put out, you know, we don't second guess what it is that works for the band. And the thing is, we stay true to ourselves. We write the music for us, for the four of us, and it comes from the heart. You know, when David sings about something, it's deep subjects, it's something that's meaningful. It's either an experience that he's gone through or we've gone through, or it's an opinion of something. It's never forcing these issues down anyone's throat and trying to preach to them. It's just a way of giving music, you know, to David, to give him, you know, a way to find an outlet and a release into these, you know, into subjects that are meaningful to us. And, you know, it's just, we're fortunate it's connected with so many people.
But is it for you because he's not afraid to speak his mind in a way? Do you always agree with him or sometimes even disagree with him, but you still let him?
I mean, there's definitely going to be some differences here and there. I mean, it's not, you know, it's...
Can you give an example, maybe? Just to give it...
Trying to pull something out of me, huh? No. I really can't, because, you know what, we don't stay on the subject too long. I mean, it's just like a married couple, you know, it's not going to be the perfect family all the time. There's going to be a disagreement, and a husband and wife will have an argument and fight. You know, and with us, it's just a matter of how much do we push the issue. If there's something that we're on a different page and we don't feel strong about, then we just move on to the next, you know, to the next idea or the next subject. And, you know, there may be an occasional thought of, you know, we've written so many songs in our career so far, 80 to 90 songs. So then, you know, sometimes there might be a suggestion thrown to David of saying, hey, you know, here's a subject idea. And, you know, how do you feel about it? And see if you could, you know, run with that idea.
Can you give maybe... We do this sometimes, but talk a little bit more in depth about a specific song, and maybe I would like to talk about The Animal, if that's possible, because okay. It's your video clip. Can you recall the first thing that maybe was or went into The Animal, a riff or a groove?
I can't remember if I did the electronics to that intro piece first. I think it was probably the riff first, and then I did a little keyboard, like kind of introduction, just kind of setting up the song, just really trying to create a different vibe, you know, something. I'm kind of the one in the band that likes spending time with, you know, just sound effects and overdubs and some keyboard synth lines and that. And it was just really, you know, just creating a vibe. And David doesn't really finalize lyrics and that until after, you know, after the melodies are established, after the music's established. And it really depends on what the music does for him, and how it moves him is going to make a difference on what it makes him feel like singing about. You know.
Does he talk to you? Maybe that's a certain element in the song triggered something in him, or?
You know, possibly. I mean, a lot of it's just kind of instinct, you know. And people always ask, you know, the signature "Down with the Sickness," how he, you know, makes that noise there, and that's kind of become the trademark. And how that came about was really just an instinct of a kind of an animalistic reaction to what that tribal drum beat did to him, and the little pause in the music, and how the band kicked in full power. It was just a reaction to, you know, all of his ideas melodically always is just like a scatting over the top of the music. At first there's no real lyrics, no nothing. It's just him kind of improvising a melody on top of that music. And so a lot of those times, some of those noises, those animalistic things are just triggered by an instinct of what that music does for him.